Hello, my dear students. I once again welcome you all for the sixth revision class on the topic Human Values of the subject PEIC. In this presentation, the important headings on sharing, caring, empathy, character, spirituality, self-confidence, and others are going to be discussed. Again, the presentation is only with respect to the important headings which are relevant to the examination question papers. Now, to start with, the difference between the sharing and the caring. So this is one of the important question, because this question is asked several times in the examination. There are five differences between caring and sharing. Let us discuss one by one with examples. The first difference. Let us come to the caring. Caring is a process which shows the interest in the welfare of others with fairness, impartiality, and justice in all activities among the employees. Whereas sharing is a process that describes the transfer of knowledge, experience, commodities, and facilities with others. Second difference. Caring is feeling for others, whereas as regards sharing is concerned, the transfer should be genuine, legal, positive, voluntary, and without any expectation in return. Coming to the third difference. Caring includes showing respect to the feelings of others and also respecting and preserving the interests of all others concerned. Whereas, with respect to sharing, through this process of sharing, experience, expertise, wisdom, and other benefits reach more people faster. Now, fourth difference. Caring can be seen in activities such as friendship, social clubs, professional societies, and through various transactions in the family, community, country, and in international concerts. Whereas sharing is voluntary and it can be driven by force but motivated successfully through ethical principles. In short, sharing is charity for the humanity. Sharing is a culture. Coming to the last difference, caring for the environment has become a necessity for our survival in the present day context. If we do not care for the environment will scare us. And coming to the sharing, economically speaking, benefits are maximized as there is no wastage or loss and everybody get one's needs fulfilled and satisfied. Commercially speaking, in sharing, the profit is maximized. Now let us discuss about the six difference in the form of examples. The examples for the caring are, first example, when a little girl drops her candy on the ground, you are getting her a new candy. This is an example of caring. One more example, when a handicapped person is crossing the road and is stuck in between the traffic, you are helping him to cross the road. It is also one type of caring. Now let us see the examples on the sharing. The first example, in the industrial area, code sharing in airlines for bookings on air travels and the common effluent treatment plant constructed for small-scale industries in the industrial estates are the examples of the sharing. The second example is, in case of sharing, the cooperative societies for producers as well as consumers are the typical examples of the goods profit and other social benefits. So this is all about the distinction between the caring and the sharing. My dear students, I am once again reminding you, it is very important question from the exam point of view. It is asked for 10 marks and as well as 5 marks. Now let us discuss the next important value, that is honesty. The question reads like this: state the specific virtues relating to honesty. So as we know, honesty is speaking the truth. Now the specific virtues relating to honesty are, the first one is beliefs, such as intellectual honesty. The second specific virtue is communication, that is writing and speech. The third virtue is decisions or the ideas. And the fourth specific virtue is actions, that is means, timing, place and the goals. And the fifth specific virtue relating to honesty is intended and unintended results achieved. Now let us move to the next question. Describe briefly empathy and self-confidence. Let us first try to know what is meant by empathy. Empathy means the ability to understand and share the feeling of others. Actually, empathy begins with showing concern and then obtaining and understanding the feelings of others. The empathy includes the imaginative projection into one's feelings and understanding of others' background, such as parentage, physical and mental state, and economic situation. Empathy is an essential ingredient for human relations and transactions. So these are the important points for the empathy. Now let us explain what is meant by self-confidence. Self-confidence is a positive attitude wherein the individual has some positive and realistic view of himself with respect to the situation in which one gets involved. The second point with respect to self-confidence is that the self-confidence in a person develops a sense of partnership, respect and accountability, and this helps the organization to obtain maximum ideas, efforts and guideline from its employees. Now, after knowing what is meant by empathy, let us try to know the benefits of empathy. The question in the examination is asked like this: list the benefits of empathy. The first benefit of empathy is there is a good customer relation. And the second benefit is there is also a good employees and employers relationship. The third benefit of empathy is good vendor-producer relationship always exists. The fourth one, the empathy develops the courage to get the success. And the fifth benefit of empathy is it maximizes the output and profit. Let us next discuss about the methods for developing self-confidence in a person. The examination question reads like this: explain the methods of developing the self-confidence. There are 5 methods of developing the self-confidence. Let us see in detail one by one. Coming to the first one, emphasize strengths. This means for every attempt, credit must be given without emphasizing the end results. One should appreciate and applaud for the efforts taken and not emphasizing on the results of the end products or projects. Second one is, second method for developing the self-confidence is taking the risks. It is better to enter onto new experience as opportunities given to learn and better rather than occasions to win or lose. This will open the new possibilities to increase the sense of self-acceptance. The third method of developing the self-confidence is self-talk. It is better to use self-talk, taking it as an opportunity to counter harmful assumptions. For example, when anyone wants to attain the expected perfections, it is better to remind himself that he cannot do everything perfectly well. And it is only an attempt in trying to do the things, and so in trying to do them well. This trial permits one to accept himself while still striving for improvement. The fourth method of developing the self-confidence is self-evaluation. In order to develop self-confidence, one should evaluate himself independently. By evaluating their strength and weakness, they can anticipate and be prepared to face the results. And the last method to develop the self-confidence is study and group discussion. So, one can develop the self-confidence on the study of the historical leaders and the innovators. Coming to the discussion on the last two morals, that is character and spirituality. The examination question is like this. Define character and spirituality. Let us first define character. Character is a characteristic property that defines the behavior of an individual. Character includes attributes that determine a person's moral and ethical actions and responses. The character is conducted through conduct, and character is determined by the expectations of the society. So these are the few points which define character. Let us define spirituality. Spirituality means the faith or belief in God regarding the worldly events. Spirituality is a process of reformation which aims to recover the original shape of man, the image of God. The spirituality functions as a fertilizer for the soil character to blossom into values and morals. Spirituality is a motivation as it encourages the persons to perform better. Lack of spirituality leads to isolation. Spirituality is also the energy. Be energetic and flexible to adapt to changing and challenging situations. And spirituality is also a fun. During working, you need to have enough ways to keep yourself charged up. So these are some points with respect to spirituality. Now, with this, we come to the end of this presentation. So if you have any doubts, my dear students, you make it free to ask at any time by contacting me or Udupudi sir. Thank you, and we shall meet you once again in the next revision class on the next topic, that is human rights.